We are going to discuss about the very very important topic, human reproductive system. What is the meaning of system? Group of organs which are useful for reproduction. Reproductive system. The group of system means group of reproductive organs. We can call reproductive system. In human reproductive system, especially what are the parts are having in human reproductive system? In male, first of all, we are going to discuss about the male reproductive system. Male reproductive system. In male reproductive system. In human being, the male reproductive system, it will be consist one pair of testes, testicles. One pair of testes, which is the oval shape, very very important. One pair of testes which are located in abdominal, extra abdominal area, in outside the body. One pair of testes, very very important organs, the primary sex organs in human beings. After that one, accessory ducts. After that one, accessory glands. After that one, external genitalia. That means whatever part is there and outside, secondary sexual organ. The primary sex organ, the important sex organ, one pair of testes. Testes are one pair. One pair means what? Two testes. And after testes, the spermatogenesis occurs in testes. Whatever raised in sperms, it is entered into the ducts. In ducts, retained testes, vasa efferentia and epididymis, vasa differences. We have to discuss about later about this. That means in women, male reproductive system consists one pair of testes, accessory ducts like retained testes, vasa efferentia, epididymis, vas difference, and next accessory glands. What are the accessory glands which are useful for, which are releasing specimen? The accessory glands are prostate gland, seminal vessels, Cowper glands or bulbourethral glands, and external genitalia outside the body, secondary sexual organ, that is penis. These are the male reproductive parts. Very very important. First of all, what are the parts having in male reproductive system? Male reproductive system having what? One pair of testes, accessory ducts, accessory glands, external genitalia. What is the meaning of accessory? Accessory means what? Helping ducts, which is useful to transport, which is useful to passing of sperms. Accessory glands, which is useful to releasing semen, nourishment, and which are sending outside the body. External genitalia. That is, these are the organs are having in human reproductive system, male reproductive system. Okay, testes is very important. These are the testes, are one pair of testes which are located in scrotal region. Now we have to discuss about, okay, just you have to, okay, now we have to discuss about what scrotum. Okay, these testes are located in outside the body, pelvic region. That means in extra abdominal. That means abdominal, outside the abdominal area, extra abdominal or pelvic region, which are located in pelvic region. These testes are located in scrotum. Okay, later we'll discuss about what is testes. Okay, which is the oval shaped testes. These testes are oval shaped or egg shaped testes, one pair of testes. These are located in scrotum. What is scrotum? Scrotum is a sac like muscular pouch. Pouch means sac like structure, which is a muscular, it is made with a muscular pouch like structure, which is in outside the body, very important for spermatogenesis. For example, this is scrotum, especially which is the pouch-like structure, which is located in outside the body. The testes are, one pair of testes are located in scrotum. The scrotum is what? Pouch-like structure. Muscular pouch-like structure. This scrotum is what? External, in outside the body. It is a sac-like structure which is hanging attached to the abdominal area. In sac-like structure, these are especially for, it consists of some muscles. These muscles are useful for in winter season and in sometimes the season we are observed what construction and relaxation of what scrotal sacs also. Scrotal sacs also, these sacs also showing what, okay, movements, especially contraction and relaxation. How is it possible these contraction and relaxation, showing contraction and relaxation? How these are showing? These are showing by, especially for, okay, we are observed here, ductus in left side, ductus muscle, and right side, if you observe there, cremastic muscle. These cremastic muscle and ductus muscles, which are located, for example, this scrotum is a skin, very thin skin, in that consist muscles. What type of muscles? Ductus muscles in left side, right side, cremastic muscles. These muscles are useful for sometimes construction and relaxation of what? Scrotal sacs. Construction of relaxation of scrotal sacs. Size, decrease the size and increase the size of scrotal sacs. The cause of ductus muscles and cremastic muscles. Okay, and now very very important. Okay, now what is the main function of scrotum? This is very important. The main function of scrotum. Scrotum is useful for spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis. That means scrotum is useful for to form sperms. That situation will provide the situation of spermatogenesis and storage of sperms. And third one, thermal control. Very very important. This is a thermal control. What is the meaning of thermal control? It controls the temperature. Who controls the temperature? Scrotal. Scrotum is what? Sac-like structure which is hanging outside. Pouch-like structure which is hanging. Which these over these going. Okay, these testes are located in scrotum, in outside the body. Testes are hanging in scrotum. In scrotum is a pouch-like structure. These pouch-like structures are showing contraction and relaxation by ductus muscles, which are located inside the skin of the scrotum and also cremastic muscles. And in scrotum, what is the use of scrotum? Scrotum is useful for spermatogenesis. And what? Okay, and storage of sperm cells. And third one, thermal control. What is the importance of thermal control? Means what? Temperature. It controls the temperature. It controls the temperature. Why it controls the temperature? Why scrotal sacs control the temperature? In scrotal sac, generally our body temperature is 37 degrees centigrade. But in scrotal region, scrotum maintain the temperature 2 to 2.5 degrees centigrade. Very very important. It's maintained. Scrotum maintains very low temperature. Why it's maintained low, very low temperature? Why it's maintained low temperature? For spermatogenesis. For spermatogenesis, need what low temperature is required. At this temperature only, sperms are storage. And also spermatogenesis is possible in testes. So that the scrotal sacs maintain low temperature. Main functions of scrotal sacs is what? Spermatogenesis, storage and thermal control. It controls the temperature. It maintain low temperature 2 to 2.5 degrees. Why it's maintain low temperature? Why? Because at the low temperature only 2 to 2.5 degrees centigrade, at this temperature only possible for spermatogenesis. Testes are possible to produce what? Sperms. so that this is the very very important sac like structure which is located extra abdominal area. Extra means outside the body, not in inside the body. It is the abdominal area, below the abdominal area, it is extra abdominal area, pouch like structures. We have observed these pouch like structures. These pouch like structures we can call scrotal sacs. These scrotal sacs are constrained and relaxed by crematic muscles and ductus muscles, and these two, this is the right side, this one is left side. Right and left two scrotal sacs separated by septal scrotum. What is septal scrotum? Septal scrotum means which separates what? Right and left side scrotal sacs. Why? Because two testes, the testicles are two, so that it is separate right and left side. The right side testicle little bit lower, but functioning is same. There is no effects in functioning. Little bit lower. Okay, the scrotal sacs is little bit hanging in down right side. Little bit. But it is not affect the in spermatogenesis. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about what? Okay. Testes. Now we are discussing about testes. Next one, testes. Testes are very very one pair means two testes are located in scrotal sacs. One pair of testes which are located in scrotal sacs. These testes are oval shaped or egg shaped structure. In the testes, for example, these testes are covering with what? Three layers. Which are one pair of testes is there? One and right side one, left side one. Scrotal septum is separate the testes. The testes is covered with what? Three membranes, three layers. What is that one? The outer layer, what we call that is tunica vaginalis. Tunica vaginalis. After that one, the inner membrane we can call, especially for tunica vasculosa, and which is covering, especially for the membrane between cavities there. We are discussing about testes. Testes are one pair which are located in scrotal region outside the body, which are located one pair of oval shaped or egg shaped structures which are located in extra abdominal cavity in scrotal region. They are hanging in scrotal region. These testes, especially for whatever is there, these testes are covered with what? Three membranes. Three layers. The three layers are tunica vaginalis, tunica vasculosa, and very very important, tunica albuginea. Okay, very very important. Why? Because this is the inner layer, the tunica albuginea. Okay, if you observe that this is what the oval shaped structure we can call what, especially for testes. This testes is covered with what? Membranes for protection. What is that one? Tunica vaginalis, tunica vasculosa, and the inner side is covering with the what? Testes is covered with tunica albuginea.
The tunica albuginea, this is the fibrous, white fibrous sheet, and it folds and forms compartments. What is the compartments? The room-like structure. It is divided in testes. Okay, for example, this is tunica albuginea and folds and forms compartments. It's not possible to show all compartment. It is divided. Tunica albuginea is the white fibrous sheet. It is forms inside the testes like compartment. How many compartment it will be formed? 200 to 300 compartment. 250 compartments also is given. 200 to, that is compartments we can call testicular compartments. Approximately 250 to 300 compartments. Testicular compartments. That means tunica albuginea folds forms compartments. That means compartments means room length. Just like it separate. Okay, one. Okay, train compartments. Okay, like that. It is a device. Room like structures. Okay, it is a compartment. How many compartment? 200 to 300 compartments. And each and every testis, it is device. Tunica albuginea foldings inside and forms compartment. We call that compartment testicular compartments. In the testicular compartments, okay, each and every testicular compartment having what? Testicular compartment, okay, I'll draw here, and each and this is one compartment. In the compartment actually foldings is there. These are, we can call, seminophoral tubules. Seminophorous tubules. These seminophorous tubules are located inside the each and every compartment. 1, 2, 3 seminophoral tubules is there. These seminophoral tubules, okay, for example, 1, 2, 3. In some compartments having only one seminophoral tubule, which is the folding sheet. Okay, one for seminophoral tubule. In these seminophoral tubules, okay, each and every seminophoral tubule, okay, these are the seminophoral tubule which are foldings. We can call seminophoral tubules. 1, 2, 3 seminophoral tubules is there. Seminophorous tubules. Each and every seminophorous tubules, it consists two types of cells. Two types of cells. One is germ cells. Second one is Sertoli cells. What is the between germ cells and Sertoli cells? That means not possible to show 250 compartments. I'm drawing some compartment only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 compartments only. But the, in that compartments, the foldings is there. That foldings we can call 1, 2, 3 foldings is there. That is we can call seminophoral tubules. These tubules are consist two types of cells. One is germ cells, other one Sertoli cells. Okay, if you draw what germ cells and Sertoli cells, the germ cells, that means it is useful for spermatogenesis. In spermatogenesis occurs in germ cells. That means the sperm's production is occurs, production of sperms occurs in germ cells. Sertoli cells giving nourishment. Nourishment means what? Nutrients to the spermatogenesis. It provides nutrients. For example, if you take one seminophoral tubule, LS of seminophoral tubules, okay, these are the seminophoral tubules. Okay, in seminophoral tubules, two types of cells is there. Some are called Sertoli cells, and which are cuboidal. Which are cuboidal in structure? Cuboidal in structure, we can call these are क्यूब स्ट्रक्चर का क्यूबॉइडियल स्ट्रक्चर दीज और लाइक दैट क्यूबॉइडियल स्ट्रक्चर्स वी कैन कॉल जर्म सेल्स ईच एंड एवरी सेल will be consist two types of one seminiferous tubule. If you took what seminiferous tubules, LS of seminiferous longitudinal section of seminiferous tubules, if you observe, we will observe two types of cells. Some cells are cuboidal structure. That cells we can call germ cells. And other cells, other cells we can call especially Sertoli cells. These Sertoli cells especially useful for giving nutrients for germination, provide nourishment to the production of germ cells. These are useful for production of spermatogenesis. And between space is there. This space is a connective tissue between seminiferous tubules having space. That space we can call intestinal space. In intestinal space, some more cells is there. That cells we can call leading cells. What we call leading cells. What is the use of leading cells? Okay, remember, the leading cells are useful for it will be releasing male androgens. What is the meaning of male androgen? Male androgen means what? Male hormones. That is what testosterone. It provides what? Testosterone. Okay? Try to remember. Here, okay, first listen. This is testes, which is oval shaped or egg shaped structure. The size of testes is, okay, 4 to 6 centimeters. The width of testes is 2 to 3 centimeters. Try to understand. This is width is 2 to 3 centimeters. The length of testes is 4 to 6 centimeters. This testes is covered with three membranes: tunica vaginalis, tunica vasculosa, and inner one tunica albuginea, which is the white fibrous sheet. This white fibrous sheet folding inside and forms compartments, testicular compartment. Each and every testicular compartments, it consists of what? Seminiferous tubules. Each seminiferous tubules contain two types of cells. That is, we can call Sertoli cells and germ cells. Germ cells produce what? Sperm cells. Spermatogenesis occurs in germ cells. Sertoli cells provides nourishment and nutrients to the production of germ cells. And between the germ cells, between the seminiferous tubules, space is there. That space we can call interstitial space. In interstitial space, leading cells is there. These leading cells releasing what? Very, very important. That is provides for male androgens. Male androgen is your male hormone, nothing but testosterone, which is a cause of what? Male characters. Okay, so that we have to write short form. Okay, just simple testicular lobules are compartments approximately 200 to 300, some books given 250 also, and each and every testicular having what? Seminiferous tubules. How many seminiferous tubules? 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules, each and every compartment. Which is the folding tubules? After seminiferous tubules, so in seminiferous tubule, two types of cells. One is germ cells and other one is Sertoli cells. Germ cells releasing what? It is useful for spermatogenesis. Sertoli cells, it is provides nourishment or nutrients to the for production of spermatogenesis. In seminiferous tubule between seminiferous tubules having space, that space we can call interstitial space. Interstitial space. In interstitial space, what type of cells? Leydig cells. Leydig cells gives what? Male androgens. Male androgen means nothing but testosterone hormone. Testosterone hormone. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about axillary ducts. Before going to discuss about axillary ducts, for example, testes, oval shaped structure, which is a oval shaped extremal structure. In testes, the inner layer is what? Tunica albuginea, which is tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea. This tunica albuginea, actually, what will be happen? It forms compartments. Already we learned it forms compartments. These compartments are especially for 250 to 300 compartments. These compartments, inside the compartment, we are observed seminiferous tubules, 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules, coil structures, seminiferous tubules. These seminiferous tubules, the end of the seminiferous tubule straight and form what? Retae testes. A seminiferous tubule, end of the seminiferous tubule. For example, okay, this is a compartment. In that compartment, these seminiferous tubules, 1, 2, 3 seminiferous tubules, the ending straight, whatever straight tubules, the end of the seminiferous tubules, combined and form a delicate tabular structures, we can call retae testes. These are the retae testes. End of the seminiferous tubules, which is the delicate. These are, we can call retae testes. Retae testes are the delicate tabular structures which are located at meristemium or end of the seminiferous tubules. Okay, end of the seminiferous, where does it is having straight structures, it forms just tubular structures, we can call these are retae testes. And the retae testes, these are open into what? Efferentia, vasa efferentia. Tubulars, one more tubulars we can call vasa efferentia, not efferentia, efferentia, vasa efferentia. These vasa efferentias are convoluted. Convoluted means what? Coil. Okay, convoluted tubules. These tubules are open into the structure. We can call these structure. We can call especially the coil structure. These structure we can call what? Epididymis. Epididymis. That means the end of the seminiferous tubules, ferrous tubules. Whatever stated end of the innocuous tubules forms one retae testis. These retae testis and these are open into vasa efferentia. What is in vasa efferentia? Convoluted tubule. That is the folding tubules. These vasa efferentia open into coil structure. The coil structure we can call epididymis. This epididymis, which is a coil structure. What is the main advantage of epididymis? This epididymis is a coil structure of tubules. It is divided into three parts. One is caput. Okay, epididymis. Second one is corpus epididymis. And third one is tail epididymis or caudal. Caudal means last. Caudal epididymis. Epididymis. Try to understand. This means, for example, semnophorous tubules are open into retae testis. Retae testis are forms tube-like structures. We can call convoluted tubules. These are we can call vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia. These vasa efferentia open into the head part of the epididymis. The head part we can call caput epididymis. Caput epididymis. Cap means head. Head or caput epididymis, other name we can call caput epididymis, or we can call head epididymis, or caput epididymis, or this is body, the middle part we can call body. This is body epididymis. After caudal means last, tail epididymis. Our other names also is there. One is caput, head cap. Caput epididymis, which is open into vasa efferentia. Our middle part we can call corpus epididymis, or we can call body epididymis. Last region we can call tail epididymis or caudal epididymis. This epididymis, what are the main functions of epididymis? The main function of epididymis, one is storage. What there are storage? The function of epididymis. Okay, function of epididymis, storage. And second one, passing or transport. What they transport? Sperm cells. That are passing through with what? It is storage. It remains some time in epididymis. Then it is a passing through with what? Through with epididymis. Into epididymis, the caudal epididymis opens into what we call, that is we can call vasa. Next part is vasa deferens. Vasa deferens, especially for, it is made up of smooth tissue, and these are also tubules. Vasa, for example, this is ovary, epididymis. These epididymis are open into tubules. We can call these tubules, we can call especially vasa deferens. Vasa differences are made up of smooth tissue, and these are not coiled tubules. Vasa efferentia is the convoluted, that means foldings, lot of folding. But vasa differences is the tubule like structure which are made up of smooth tissue. These vasa differences, the main function is they are passing the sperm cell through with them, and these are open into, we can call urethra. Urethra is the common passage of urine and sperm cells. Urethra into
especially urethra, so that we can call urethra is the next part after urethra, urethral meatus. Urethral meatus opens into the penis. Urethral meatus. These are, especially we are observed, these are the accessory ducts which is the passing the sperm cells through with them. What are accessory ducts? Easy to learn. How we will learn accessory ducts? Accessory means helping. How they are helping? Accessory, the main function of accessory ducts are two functions. What are they? Accessory ducts main function is accessory ducts main function is storage of sperm cells and transport or passage of sperm cells. This is the main function of what? Accessory ducts. The first one, seminiferous tubules. Seminiferous tubules. These are opening to what? Retail testes. Retail testes are opening to vasa efferentia, which is convoluted fully. Efferentia. Vasa efferentia opening to vasa efferentia epididymis. Epididymis opens into vasa deferens. Vasa deferens opens into urethra. Urethra opens into penis. That is the genital port. These are what? The passage of what? Sperm cells. Sperm cells are passing through these ducts. So that you have to remember the names. First, very easy. First, testes, which is the oval shaped structure. The testes are open into what we call, this is the retail testes. Retail testes, tubules are formed, convoluted tubules are formed. These are, we can call vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia opens into head of the what we call epididymis. Epididymis opens into vasa efferentia. Vasa differences opens into what? Urethra. Urethra opens into penis. These are the parts especially for useful to passage and storage of what? Storage of sperm cells. Especially epididymis, these are the head region, caput epididymis, carpus epididymis, caudal means last, caudal epididymis, caput epididymis, carpus epididymis, and third one is caudal epididymis. Or if you thought that easy to learn, head epididymis, body epididymis, and caudal means tail epididymis. This epididymis is what? Coil structure. So many coils, the tubules are coiled. Coil structures. These coil structures are open into vasa differences. Vasa differences is the tubular structures. Tubular structure which is just passing what? Sperm cells into urethra. Urethra opens into urinogenital pore and urethral meatus into penis. Next we have to discuss about what? Next one, what? Accessory glands we have to discuss. Now we are going to discuss what? Accessory glands. These glands are useful for what? Nutrition. Provide the nutrition to the what? Sperm cells, and the nourishment to the sperm cells. Provides nutrients to the sperm cells. What are accessory glands? Accessory glands are seminal vesicle, prostate gland 1, and bulbo urethral glands. In male reproductive system,
in human being, male reproductive system, three types of axillary glands. One is seminal vesicles, one pair of seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle opens into urethra, urethra opens into seminal vesicle. That means the sperm cells are enter into the vasa, through with vasa differences, sperms are enter into the urethra, in urethra, through with urethra, it is open into seminal vesicle. Seminal vesicle release into urethra, seminal vesicle release into urethra some fluid. That fluid is what we call, that fluid we can call semen. That means seminal vesicle released what? It released some fluid, alkaline fluid. That fluid name is what? Semen. In that semen, actually some type of enzymes and also vitamin C, fructose, that means it provides the nutrients to the sperm cells. Seminal vesicles releasing what? It producing what? Semen. Semen is what? Alkaline fluid. This alkaline fluid contains fructose, vitamin C, enzymes, some type of hormone. These are useful for to provide the nutrients to the sperm cells. They provide the nutrients to the sperm cells. So that these seminal vesicles releasing semen into the urethra. And next gland is prostate gland. Second gland is what? Prostate gland. One prostate gland is located below the seminal vesicle. This prostate gland, especially it is releasing what? The milky-like substance. Just fluid. This is also fluid. Milky-like substance. That milky-like substance, that means we can call prostate fluid. That is useful for easy moving of sperm cells in urethra. The movement of, it is useful for motile of sperm cells. What is the meaning of motile? Moving in urethra. So that it is a milky-like substance, is releasing milky-like substance, prostate gland. That milky-like substance we can call prostate fluid. That is useful for motile, moving of sperm cells. After that one, bulbourethral or Cowper glands. Glands, Cowper glands. Bulbourethral or Cowper glands, these are okay, rich, having what? Rich in mucoproteins. It contains mucoproteins. It is that fluid also. It is also releasing fluid. These are also useful for lubricate. Lubricate of what? Especially for sperm cells. It provides the nutrients and lubricate the sperm cells, and also very, very important, neutralize the acidic urine, whatever remaining in urethra. Okay, one concept you have to discuss. Urethra is a urinogenital pore or tube. Urinogenital, the word. That means through with urethra, urine is passing. And genital means what? Sperm cells are also passing through with only one duct, that is urethra. Through with urethra, urine and sperm cells are passing through with only one duct, that is urethra. Urethra opens into urethra's meatus. Okay, but here we are discussing about axillary glands. These axillary glands provide what? Nutrients and also what? Fluid. They are releasing fluid, they lubricate and provide the nutrients to the sperm cells. All are especially for seminal vesicle, prostate gland, okay, bulbourethral or Cowper gland. These glands are what? Produce what? Fluid like substance. This fluid like substance is useful for motile, provides nourishment, and also useful for, it gives some nutrients to the sperm cells. Okay, now part of what? Sexual reproduction, male reproductive system. That is, we can call, okay, external genitalia. What is that external, outside, which is useful for ejaculation, which is useful for sending outside, which is useful to sending the sperm cells into female body. which is that is secondary sexual character of the male reproductive system, that is nothing but we can call penis. The penis, what is the main function of penis? The sperm cells are passing through with accessory ducts, through with urethra, opens into what? Penis. In penis, through with penis, it is sending to the female body. It is sending whatever sperm cells are enter into the female body through with what? Penis. Penis is the external. External. So that we are using external genitalia. That is the external organ. Secondary sexual organ. In that, this what? This part of this penis actually, this is made up of blood vessels. Okay, so that I have to draw rough diagram. Okay, it is made up of what? Okay, urethra. Urethra. Okay, sorry. This is urethra. It is open into urethra, meatus, and this is the foreskin of penis. Okay. Anyway, here if you observe it there, okay, this penis is made up of what? Blood vessels, and it is connective tissues is there, and in that erectile, that mean when the mating is occurs, especially at the time, it is the organ, okay, contraction and relaxation, showing the contraction and relaxation, and it's erect. Why? Because it erect straight, okay, it is standing in straight. How it is possible means what? In that erectile tissue is there. Try to remember the names. That's why we are explaining. Erectile tissue is corpus cavernosum. Cavernosum and carpus spongiosum, carpus cavernosum. These are the erectile tissue. That means it is what sometimes it will become strong. The reason of what? The tissue is located carpus cavernosum and carpus spongiosum. Okay, the main function of external genitalia, that is the penis, or it is sending the sperm cells into female body. It is useful for ejaculation, sending ejaculation of sperm cells. Okay, thank you.